YARA rules are powerful pattern matching tools for identifying, classifying, and detecting malicious activity. Malware analysts, security researchers, and incident responders use them to defend against malware and hunt for the bad guys. They are also one of the fundamental pieces of tactical intelligence you will share with operational teams as a cybersecurity analyst. So you better know what they are, and let's dive in. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Adam and I teach everything about CTI. I've helped build CTI teams, refine processes, and train clients on best practices. If you want to learn it all for free, subscribe to this channel. YARA is a key concept for any cybersecurity professional to learn. They are the key piece of tactical intelligence that lets you and your team identify, classify, and detect malicious activity. Let's explore what they are and how you can use them. YARA is a powerful pattern matching tool for searching through data in memory dumps, packet captures, or binary files for specific patterns. It is used in cybersecurity to detect malware and hunt for indicators on endpoints. This makes it useful across various fields and disciplines. You can think of YARA as GREP, or regular expressions, on steroids. Its advanced pattern matching features, extension modules, and wide adoption in the malware analysis and incident response communities make it a game changer. As a threat intelligence analyst, you must become familiar with understanding, handling, and creating your own YARA rules. They are an essential part of your tactical intelligence toolkit and help operational teams proactively hunt for malicious activity. The team behind VirusTotal maintains YARA to help malware researchers identify and classify malware samples. The tool has become a staple in the cybersecurity community. It is widely used by security researchers, analysts, and security tooling. Let's explore what a YARA rule actually looks like so you can begin using them. But hold on a second. I want to hear from you guys. Do you already know about YARA rules and use them in your daily work? Or do you want to start using them but don't know how? I'd love to hear how you guys are using YARA or how you want to use it in the future. Leave your answers in the comments. The most basic YARA rule will consist of three main sections. You have the meta section, which contains metadata about the rule, like its name, a brief description of what it detects, the author of the rule, and references to CTI sources. Then you have the string section. This section defines the binary strings or patterns the rule should match against. They can be plain text strings enclosed in double quotes, hexadecimal byte sequences enclosed in curly brackets, or regular expressions enclosed with a forward slash.
Finally, the condition section, where the logic of the rule is stored. This section defines the criteria required to trigger the rule using Boolean logic and the data described in the string section. YARA rules are typically broken into individual files ending in .yar, each targeting a specific malware variant, TTP, or threat actor.
That said, you can combine multiple YARA rules into a single file or import other rules into your file. Once you've created a YARA rule or set of rules, you can use the YARA command line tool or another security tool that uses the YARA engine to test the target, like a file, folder, or process, against your rule. Executing YARA, followed by the name of your rule, and then your target, we'll scan the file with the YARA executable. Here, sample.exe and sample2.exe are scanned using the rule.yar YARA rule.
You can see sample.exe matches against a rule in this file named malicious file, whereas the sample2.exe file does not. There's no output.
Other popular alternative applications that allow you to run YARA rules, along with common detection rule formats like IOC list or Sigma rules, include Thor and Thor Lite by Nextron Systems, Invoke YARA, which lets you run YARA through a PowerShell script, and the popular Performant Endpoint Visibility Platform OS Query. In addition to applications, there are add-ons that allow you to use YARA with popular tools like Burp Suite, Ida Pro, Binary Ninja, Cutter, or Firefox, and wrappers or bindings for popular programming frameworks like C#, Go, OCaml, Java, and Rust. This compatibility allows you to integrate YARA into your own custom tools. YARA was originally written in Python, so don't worry if you're a Python fan. There are plenty of Python modules to create, parse, and run YARA rules. One of YARA's key features is its ability to match various types of strings against files.
The most popular of these is hexadecimal byte sequences, because attackers find them difficult to hide or obfuscate in binary files. Because of this, YARA includes special hex values to make pattern matching more versatile.
You can use wildcards that let you use the question mark to match any single byte in a hexadecimal string. For example, 01?03 would match any sequence that starts with 01, followed by any byte, and then a 03. You can also use ranges, which represent consecutive bytes in a hexadecimal string, using the hyphen character. For example, 01-02-04 would match any sequence that starts with 01, followed by any byte between 0 and 04. Or use alternatives to provide different options for a given fragment of a hex string. You could use 62B4-56 to match 62B4-56. This is similar to the OR Boolean operator. You can even change these special values together to create complex patterns. This is just a taste of YARA's string matching capabilities. For a complete reference guide on text and regular expression capabilities, see the documentation on writing rules. Another key feature of YARA is its powerful modules, which provide additional functionality beyond the core features of the YARA engine. For example, to search for files with a file name explorer.exe and that are of an uncommon size, you can use this rule. This rule uses the uint16 function to search for magic bytes 0x5a4d. This is the MZ header present in all PE files. It then uses the file module to match explorer.exe and file size range to find files less than 1,000 kilobytes or greater than 3,000 kilobytes. You can use community modules or write your own to express more complex conditions. Modules are written in C and built into YARA at compile time. Creating your own YARA modules is outside the scope of this video, but for a complete guide, read the documentation. Now that you have a basic understanding of YARA rules and how to create them, let's explore some tips to help you get started. YARA rules can range from simple ones that match a text string to extremely complex ones that use multiple modules and conditions to avoid triggering false positives. At times, YARA can seem like a never-ending battle to create a detection rule that accounts for all possible false positives, but is not too specific to exclude malware variants. This can quickly add complexity to your rule, impact the performance, and make it hard to maintain. To help you combat these challenges, here are some useful tips for writing effective YARA rules to help you get started. First, remember to read the documentation. The documentation is the first step in creating YARA rules. Here you will find everything you need to start, including instructions on writing rules and references to using specific tool features. Next, remember to start simple. Begin by defining the purpose and objective of your rule and create simple detection logic that meets these requirements. Don't try to go all in from the start by importing several modules or matching all edge cases. Start simple and build up your rule over time to reduce the false positives that you encounter. The simpler the rule, the faster it will run. Also, use descriptive names. Use a name that clearly describes the purpose or functionality of your YARA rule. Using generic names or numbers is useless if you intend to share it with the wider community. It also makes your rules harder to manage as your rule set grows. Document. Document your rules with metadata. Include it in every rule you run. Should always include documentation that describes its purpose, the type of thread it targets, and any relevant references or sources it uses. This data will help other analysts and future you understand and use your rules effectively. Also, thoroughly test your YARA rules. YARA rules will generate false positives where they trigger on legitimate binaries, or false negatives when they don't trigger when you want them to. The only way to find these is to rigorously test your rule against diverse samples, including malicious and benign files. Also, try to collaborate with others when building YARA rules. YARA has been widely adopted in cyber by a thriving community of enthusiasts and professionals. Use this to your advantage. Collaborate with other cybersecurity professionals, exchange rules and insights, and contribute to community-driven threat intelligence efforts. Another tip is to leverage contextual information, like file metadata and attributes. This can be incredibly useful in enhancing the accuracy of your YARA rules. If you know a piece of malware is always a certain size, or always includes a certain PE header attribute, you can instantly filter out anything that doesn't match these requirements. Finally, tune how specific your rules are. Not all YARA rules are designed to fulfill the same purpose. Some are used to hunt potentially malicious behavior and may generate more false positives to spread a wider net, while others are more focused on detecting specific threats and will only trigger if they find something malicious. Ensure you define your rule's purpose. It will affect how specific you want to make it. If you're struggling to get started or want to know how your rule compares to others, check out these free learning resources. At this point, you may think, YARA rules are great. Why not use them for everything? Unfortunately, like everything in security, they have moments of brilliance and real-world limitations. Here are some of the common limitations you will face when trying to use YARA at your organization. Although many open source tools and projects support YARA rules, commercial vendor support is low. Due to its performance overhead of running YARA rules, many SIEM or EDR providers do not allow users to custom YARA rules. However, technological advancements are slowly changing this, like with the new YARA standard coming out. Another limitation is complexity. Writing effective YARA rules requires malware analysis skills and a good understanding of the YARA syntax, regular expressions, and binary file formats. These concepts often require a steep learning curve and can be challenging for beginners to grasp. The performance impact of running YARA is also a limitation. Scanning files or processes with YARA rules can be an intensive process that requires significant computational resources. Another limitation is the rule maintenance required. Building your own set of custom detections requires keeping up with emerging threats, new malware families, and changes in attack techniques. This requires regular maintenance and reviews of your YARA rules, which can become time-consuming and resource-intensive for your security team. Finally, YARA has trouble scaling. Applying YARA rules to large datasets or high-volume traffic streams can impose performance overhead on those systems and networks. These limitations can make automating and scaling YARA across your enterprise challenging. You must carefully consider the implications of using YARA before incorporating it into your real-world workflows. That said, if you are smart about where and when you use YARA rules, the benefits will outweigh the limitations for most organizations. Another important factor to consider when using YARA rules is the type of malware that runs against them. These days, most malware is packed, encrypted or obfuscated to make it difficult to detect, and then unpacked at runtime. YARA struggles to detect packed malware. The real value of YARA comes when you can write rules that detect things in unpacked malware. This could mean executing YARA rules against the running process or performing dynamic malware analysis. Before you start scanning all your systems using YARA rules, think about what your YARA rules are actually searching for. Using and understanding YARA rules is a fundamental skill for anyone in a technical cybersecurity role. Their powerful pattern matching capabilities and detect malicious activity in files, data, and running processes. This makes them a key piece of intelligence for threat hunting, incident response, and malware analysis. Now that you know how to create a YARA rule, give it a go. Start by adapting other people's rules and using resources like the YARA toolkit to begin using this awesome technology. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like to let me know you want to see more of this content.